I created this file ahead because don't know what the question is going to be. Let me change the date from the 27th to the 28th. Description to create a scheme code that will display all members of your team on separate lines. Okay. What to do, what to do. Parentheses display. I don't know what team I'm going to be, but let's say team. Well, based on Campus Wire, it's a team one, so I might do that. Display my name, Frederick Glenn Braun. New line. Let me see. What would be my other people's names since I don't know who they're going to be? Could do display. Team. I know that's fix that. So we do. You know what? Since my favorite number is number two, let's do that. Team two. Second member. New line. Display team. To third member. Exit. Let me check the servers to see if it's actually 3 members. Yep, we'll be working in a team of 3. Unless it's under Microsoft Teams. Well, nah, that'll be clicking in and out, so it does have to wait. Let me fix the spacing. That'd be good. And I think the code for saving it is CX and CS, and for sorry about that. Sent to S. Let's scheme into .1. Don't know what's the code to leave. I think it's Cinto X and Cinto C. Let's give that a try. Sorry about that. Wrong one. Let's try my code to see if it's working completely. GSI scheme intro 1.scm, and we have a code, team 2 members, which is me, Frederick Lynn Braun, and my 2 other members that we might be assigned next week. Okay. Let me go back to the code. Sorry. And I I thought I was wrong. I had to do this. Okay. Well, I'm fine. Display. Team 2 members. New line. Display Frederick Lynn Braun. New Line. Display. Team. 2 second member. New line, then display team to third member. Then we have exit. Okay, number one is done. First game into it, number two. I have to exit out real quick since I don't know what the hell I'm doing. Trusting you, it's safe. Yes, I want to close this session. Don't worry, be back in a few minutes. And I have to do it again. Yay. If you want to go ahead and see me writing the code, be my guest. And I talk too much, I'm sorry. I don't like that. That's better. Okay, time to start writing the code. You want to enter the numerator in the denominator. Okay. Then with the two reads, that means you can put two. Be 100 because. Why not? What am I missing? See. Dominator makes sense. Let's try that. Okay. Central X, Central S. SCE, DME into 2.CM. Okay. Central X, Central C. DSI. Errors. Okay, that means the code's not working. Let's see. So we have pregnancy here, the pregnancy machine was here, and we have the pregnancy. Maybe it needs. Maybe another pregnancy? Okay, that's what I'm missing. Okay. Okay. Central X. No. Central S. Okay. Central X. Central C. GSI. Let's try 100%. If that's correct, yep. Let's try the other two examples. Sorry if I'm being talkative. This is my second time doing YouTube. Okay, seems like the code working perfectly. So let's put it down to the question. Let's see. Parentheses, 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 okay. Display. Oh. Probably don't need that one. Okay, and exit. Okay. Scheme into three, find gambit, okay. Please be on trees and really trees and love information about the tree function. Okay. And run, okay, with the number change of course, and I'm giving a Fibonacci number and trace the results. Okay, simple enough. Didn't know it's gonna do that. Maybe it only is when you not doing it. Okay. Lesson learned. Number and trace the result. New function select. Two, I don't like that. How much time do I have left? I have 57 minutes, which is good enough for me. And I need to stop doing that. Okay, let's see the code I need to write. Okay. Define fact in if two one in fact so that let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 okay. Trace fact fact 5. And let's put accent for now. X into S, K sends into X into C, genius I scheme maybe doesn't need the accent. Create an into 1 minus n 1 trace facts fact 5 okay then send
damn it
okay. Unbound variable. Okay. Let's see. Yeah. Okay, understand why the spacings. Okay. Okay, maybe the spacings are causing why? Okay. Let's see. It's fine. Yeah. So when n is the variable, so we need to. Okay. Yes, fix all the errors. So Let's try again. Okay, so we have fact 5, fact 4, fact 3, fact 2, fact 1, which gave us 120, 24, 6, 2, 1. So we need to change the code. Okay. Well, let's see. You got 10. You have to give me 5, so I'm guessing the fact has to. It's a bit me. It's 5. See, define. See. Because you want us to do the 10 numbers. Consequences will be, or no, the consequences are the results. Okay. Let's see, so 1, 2, 6, 124, 120, so this would be 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13. You 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, okay. Sorry about that. Let's see. Zero plus one. Plus one would be two. Where is it? 24 to 120, that would be times by 5. But we don't want, so it's multiplying. So it'd be 1 times 1 be 1. No, it'd be so. Wait. But it stopped because I did 10. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Wait. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Right, but if you want the Fibonacci value of 10, you might have to do 11. So I'll fib because Fibonacci sequence. Let's see. So you want to multiply, so if 9, let's see, if it's 1, 6, so we have 35 would be 120, but the 24, so the that'd be times 4, that'd be times 3, that'd be times 2. Okay, so it's multiplication, but we're doing adding, so I have to change the multiplication symbol to plus. Okay. How many time we have left? 43 minutes. Okay. That would be minus, so let's see, 4 was 1, but you minus 1, every time we put 1, it would be 1, then it would be 2 minus to three. Rid of something. So wait. A+4, 13. That'd be 7. B+4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10. Okay. What do I need to add? Let's say this is very same with them, but then it would be a T5, so N-1. What happened if I do Fib? Yeah. N-2. So it trace fib, then fib 10, but let me change that to 11. See, if any of the fact fib, we change the multiplication to plus. Change the 2 to 3, and I add another fib. Only then, damn it. What did I do wrong? Let's see here. Define fib n if n is 3, 1. What's n fib? Try to fib unless I have to do. This way. Okay. Let's see. You see, if n is less than 3. Okay. So it's starting with 0. So it would be 0, so if 1, 1 plus 1, so it'd be 0 plus 1 would be 1. Then we get rid of the other 1. Then we do 2. How this works. Doing What happened if I do that? Okay, so Chris, we Chris, but. Do not want that. Then that means if I'm doing that, well, 10 is the parameter, so that means I need to change this to read. I don't know why I want to skip the zero. So they're saying if the parameter is zero, what? So then make that exit 2 for 2. Okay, let me try this again. Okay, let's see. So if we're doing, let's see. If it's starting as saying 0 is 1, well, let me see if what happened if I do this again. Do that. Okay. Okay. What happened if I add? Okay, this is gonna be it. What happened if I put 0? Okay. Stupid mistake. Be 1, so let's see, we have parentheses with that, if we have parentheses into that, Thank you. Okay. Learn my lesson. So it's multiply, so that's what the run is. Good to know. Okay. Why? Let's try two again. Don't know when I want to do that. Well, it's got 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13. 21, 34, 55, but give me a 9, which is kind of true. If you do the math, okay. So we wanted to be at 3. Let's see. Fib, and so you're doing Fibonacci in. Okay. N minus 2, then N minus 1. Okay, so that's what makes. Okay, so let's see. So, okay, got it. So, seven, n, so if n is greater than, if n is less than 3, one plus n minus 2 should be n minus 2. But we got n minus 1. Interesting. Plus 5 and minus 2. Minus n 2 3 minus 2 3. Then we add the 5. Yeah, but what time do we have left? 50 minutes. Ugh, not enough time. Okay, so let's see. In the 3, if we wanna keep the in. See if it has a cigarette. Let's see, you got rid of, let's see. Okay, let's see. In 3, because you need. Okay, so 0, 0, 0, 3, 1. Yeah, I won't put 0. So it's done as 1, but then we get 2. Let's see. 2 is 2 and 3 is 1, so 2 minus 1 will be 1. 2 minus 1 is 1. Now hold up. 1 plus. So let's see. If I do 2 is less than 3. 2 minus 2 will be 0. But 2 minus 1 will be 1. That's 1. Okay, so 3 minus 3 is 3 minus 2 will be 1. 3 minus will be 2. Wait, 3 minus 3 minus 2 will be 1. And 3 minus 1 will be 2, so that makes it 1 plus 1 equals 2. Okay, so how do you get 0 and 1? -2 will be -2, but then you have -1, and interesting. If n is the -3. Well, I think, whoops. But what about 4? So then, okay, so 3 is greater than 3. Multiply by. Okay, so that's 1. -1 and -2, unless it's. Well, unless you do n-2, it makes it. No. Input 3. Input 3. What makes it Fibonacci of 2? So it'd be, well, unless we do it 0. One, or at least we do plus 0 and 0 will be 0. No, no, no. Hold up. Let's see here. What are we doing? It's a 10. But then we're down at 12. Let's see, what am I going to do? 4. 4 minus 2 would be 2. 4 minus 1 would be 3, 2, yeah. So how do I get it? 1. You can't. The only, unless, what would be 2 plus 3 would be 2. No. That's a hardy one. This out. Just adding the thing, but won't make any sense because it should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You're doing 9. Okay. Fib n, parenthesis if n, n 3, 1, fib n raised to parenthesis, fib n, n raised to 5, 3, 4, 5, trace fib, fib read, okay, exit. Team 2 member, second, team 2 second member, team 2 third member. Enter the memory in the generator display. Star slash read read 100. Display. Exit. Okay. This is Frederick Braun, class of computer science 314, core, yeah, and my professor is Dr. Lupoli, I think. Oh, my bad, Professor Lupoli. And this is my code for Scheme Info Lab. Submitting the quiz. And see you next week.